In this tutorial, we'll be setting up our audio and MIDI devices for Reason 5 creations. We first need to go to the Go menu and Utilities folder. Or you can go Apple Shift U to open up the Utilities window. We'll then double click on the Audio MIDI setup. I have it already open, so I'll just bring it up here. In this window, you can see all the MIDI devices I have connected to my computer. The Fast Track Ultra is my main audio and MIDI interface, and that is where most of my connections will be coming to and from. The Yamaha M08 is greyed out because it is not currently connected. If I double click on the network purple button, you can see I have my iPad wirelessly connected and ready to connect via MIDI. All I have to do is select Samuel Wright's iPad, click connect, and little red bars will appear to say that yes, my iPad is ready to go and the keyboard is working. Now that is for setting up MIDI devices. What if you wanted to set up your audio? You go to the window menu and say Show Audio Window. Up comes all of the audio in and out devices available for my Mac. My M-Audio Fast Track Ultra will be my main audio in and out device when I use Reason. You can set up any other device you like. Just make sure that you know where the audio is coming from and where it is going. Now we need to set up our audio and MIDI within Reason. To bring up the Reason Preferences menu, you use Command or Apple comma, and take the top drop-down menu to Audio. As you can see, the green tick indicates my audio device is the M-Audio. And if we use keyboards and control surfaces, you can see my Korg and Mackie control or iPad control surface are all connected and ready to go via the green ticks next to them. Even my guitar synth is ready to go. These steps are outlined in your booklet. Make sure you go over them for troubleshooting and to double check if you have problems with audio or MIDI going in and out of Reason. If you move on to video 5, we will undertake our first recording session in Reason.